from my heart and from my hand. Why don't people understand my intention?
Hi, Trader. Tina here once again from ShortMeTina.com with my daily recap. Happy Monday. Welcome back. I hope you had an enjoyable and pleasant weekend. If you did anything fun and you want to share, comment in the comment section and let us know what you did for the weekend. So let's get some things out of the way before we recap the overall markets, right? Interesting day. So let's start it off with our mission again. I think it's fitting to start our videos off with our mission because it kind of sets the tone for what we do. Our mission is to build a powerhouse of successful traders and to help you find more winners. We conclude, if you win, we win. Before I get to the other thing, let me welcome you. If this is your very first time tuning in to a Short Me Tina video, I'd like to say welcome. Thanks for dropping in. Thanks for listening. Comment in the comment section and let us know it's your first time. If you are returning, thanks for sticking with us again. I know you can be doing a gazillion other things, but in this moment, you choose to spend it with us here at the Short Me Tina community. So that's out the way. Again, our mission is to build a powerhouse of successful traders. Before we can do that, let us know what your biggest struggle is in trading. It's super important to let us know that. It's super important to verbalize it and vocalize it. Again, we're here to help. Thirdly, what are the three pillars of successful trading? So if you spent your weekend doing something extremely fun, I did as well. On Saturday, I went to I went to my daughter's open mic. That was fun. Sunday, I spent all day doing some things on the administrative end for Short Me Tina, in addition to crafting this video on what are the three pillars of successful trading. If you want to take a stab at it, sure, go ahead. You can comment in the comment section, but I will link it in this video. So definitely check that out. In my opinion, if you want to be successful, you need to have these three foundational principles. And lastly, we ended the month of May on Friday. Was the last trading day for the month of May. I encourage you to review your performance again. We use a trading journal here. I also have a video that I will link on what metrics we tend to use when we're analyzing our performance. Again, it's super important. Analyzing your performance, looking at your weak spots, looking at your strong suits will only make you better. Again, trading, in many respects, it's very simple. If you want to get to that next level in your trading, you have to put in the work, okay? It'll take some time. You can definitely achieve success, but you have to put in some work. It's not going to just happen overnight. Once again, you have to put in some work. But I'm here, we're here to guide you, to help you out. All right, so let's kick it off with the recap of the overall markets. All right, so we have the SPY S&P 500 daily chart. What did we close at today? We closed at 274.61, one as low as 273.09. For me, overall, it was an okay day, right? Things were pretty all right to me. Things could have ended a lot worse today considering the price action of the markets for the past 3 or 4 weeks. And the fact, again, that we closed relatively close to the low on Friday. Friday wasn't the best day. Considering all that, I think we kind of escaped today relatively. We fared well, in my opinion. Let's just say that. So what am I paying attention to? I'm still paying attention to 280 to 282, that once resistance, then support, now resistance level. All in all, just to keep it really short, while if you go back to March of 2019, right, for the past 3 months or so, there has been, on some levels, shorter-term weakness in the market. Overall, I still think the market is in a bullish uptrend. So I'm inclined to lean more towards the bullish side. So for things to get going, again, I will be paying attention to that 280 level. if today's low can serve as a floor, and I believe it will, if 273 overall can serve as a floor, I think that that would be great for the market. So that's basically what I'm paying attention to. Full disclaimer, full disclosure. Yes, we are short the market, but that we placed that short on a few weeks ago as a, in my opinion, as a hedge. I just wanted to hedge our portfolio, which was at that time mainly long. Okay, so while we are short the market, we are in profit. I still believe the market will see 300 within this calendar year. What else? All right, the IWM daily chart. So closed at 146.39. We broke, as it states here, shorter term support of 148 to 150. Sometimes these things tend to happen, all right? Sometimes the markets do plow through these very obvious support levels. I'm thinking that might be the case with ticker IWM or this particular ETF. Obviously, time will tell. If that is the case, then we should, I would say, within this week, relatively soon, rather. It shouldn't take us next week or the week after. Within this week, we should get above that 148 level. If we can do that, I think we're things are good. Obviously, we're still going to be paying attention to that longer term resistance of 160, but first things first, we need to get back over that 148 level. One support, now resistance. If we can get back over there, I think more than likely we're going to retest 160, and hopefully this time around we'll break it and sustain that break. So all in all, I am not tremendously bearish on the market. I am still bullish on the market. I'm still looking for longs. I'm not really focusing on shorts, right? What else? All right, and so obviously I'm going to mention and talk about ticker ZNGA. Again, I'm not trying to push it or pump it. We've already realized substantial gains in this particular stock. Again, we got into it in the low to mid three, so we've definitely capitalized off of this move. But looking at the chart, I cannot help but to remain bullish. Granted, today was a bit of an off day, and I think that that's perfectly fine. Again, sometimes you want stocks to pull back after they've had a huge run so they can, again, quote unquote, digest the move. So these pullbacks I'm perfectly fine with, off about 3% on the day, closed at 609. Even if it pulls back more and we dip into the fives, for me, that would be the prime opportunity to actually jump into this trade. So, I'm waiting for a spot to actually add to my already existing position, because I see this at some point hitting $8 within 2019. Again, if you look at the chart dating back to 2012, we've traded more or less under that 630 level, and for the past few trading weeks, we've actually made a lot of attempts to surpass that level. And like I've indicated before, the more times a stock tries to breach a certain level, whether it be resistance or support, the likelihood of it actually occurring increases. So I want Zynga to continue making attempts at breaching this, we can call this 7-year wall right here, because once it actually breaks free, you can see here there's very little overhead. So for me, the chances or the odds of it running, it's good in my book. So again, to recap, ticker ZNGA, remain bullish. I see this as an $8 stock. What else? And then we have ticker VISL daily chart dating back to 2018. But let's focus in on price action starting January of 2019. Huge day for the bulls. Congrats. Stock went as high as 374. We closed at 297, so it's up about 80% on the day. Again, great move with confirming volume right here. But if you pay attention to where the stock actually closed, we closed below that support level of, let's say, $3. We're not too far from it. Closer to 297. However, going into tomorrow, the remainder of the week, if we cannot get above that $3 level, I think the story is over. Expect a sell-off. What else? And then we have ticker ADRO daily chart. dating back to June of 2018, but let's focus in on price action beginning October of 2018 after the stock gapped down. So again, we're off 40% on the day, closed at 194. If you go back to October of 2018, you can see that the chart is technically broken again if you go back here, because that support of 250 or that support level of $2.50 has held for the past 7 or so months. Fast forward to today, and we clearly broke that support of 250 with confirming volume closed at 194. The low clocked in at 181. So we've had a bit of a bounce off of the 181 lows. I would not jump into this stock as of yet. Again, for me, the chart looks technically broken. If you're looking for a longer, you must play this on the long side. I'd wait for the stock to actually settle. Any stock that sheds 40%, that's a big deal. That's a huge deal. There's something internally wrong with any stock that's shedding 40% in a day. At any rate, for me, for the stock to look technically quote-unquote okay, it needs to get back above and hold that multi-month support of 250. What else? And then we have Amazon ticker AMZN daily chart off north of 5% on the day. Closed at $1,691.80. So for me, you know, I love to trade my ranges, and I feel I've identified one with Amazon. Not necessarily the best range, but a range or a channel nonetheless, dating back to 2018. And if you know anything about how I trade ranges or channels, you buy support. And again, if you haven't seen that video, I'm going to link it here. So for me, Amazon is definitely on my watch list. I don't own it yet, but I'm waiting for it to get to that lower end or the lower end of the channel, and then I'm going to buy, because, you know, if you look at the chart dating back, and I this chart only goes back to 2017, but if you take a longer term view, I mean, even going back to 10 years, you'll see that Amazon is in a clear uptrend. So that was my alarm. At any rate, so like Amazon, put it on your watch list. I'm not quite sure what's going to get it to the lower end of support, but I'm sure some news will break where it's going to have a sell-off. Again, use that moment of fear to buy. Learn how to buy fear. So I'm putting Amazon on my watch list because it looks like it's going to be a good buy at some point. What else? And let's wrap it up and round it out with GOOGL daily chart again, or Alphabet, whatever it's calling itself these days. So off about 6%, closed at $1,038.74 on confirming volume, similar to Amazon range. If you take a look at the longer term chart going back 10-15 years, clear uptrend. I like the stock, I like the chart, I like the company. Again, I'm not quite sure what's going to take it to the lower end of support. Doesn't necessarily matter to me. I'm just going to wait until it gets to the lower end of support. If that can hold, I will be buying around here. So definitely put GOOGL on your radar, put it on your watch list. And let's cap it there. Tina here once again from ShortMeTina.com. If you enjoyed any portion of this video, I would like for you to do 3 things for me. At the beginning of this video, I asked a ton of questions, right? I said, hey, what did you do this weekend? Comment in the comment section. I said, hey, what is your biggest struggle in trading? Comment in the comment section. I also said, hey, I'm going to link to you what I believe are the 3 foundational principles of successful trading. Listen to that video, then come back. Comment in the comment section. I also encourage you on Friday and today to do a end of month performance review, meaning look at your trading for the past 6 months, right? We're mid-year, or you can look at it for the past month or 2 weeks. Let me know the findings. What do you see? Does anything jump out at you, right? Because in order for you to improve your performance, you need to evaluate it. So let me know in the comment sections some of the cool things or the interesting things that have come up with your evaluation. So that's the first thing I ask you to do. Well, not one thing, I actually do tons of things, all right? Anyway, secondly, if you want more videos like this, I do them Monday through Friday. Whenever the stock market is open, expect a video. If you want to be notified, head on over to our YouTube channel at ShortMeTina and hit that subscribe button. And lastly, I've been trading for well over 15 years. If you think you can learn anything from me, then head on over to ShortMeTina.com, sign up, become a member. Thank you for listening, and as always, thank you for the support. Making dreams come true, living tissue, warm flesh, we're